when we first meet Peter, which is in the opening scene, the guy has all the answers. He's lived his life kind of on a plan. He knows exactly what he wants. Here's a guy that is not asking the questions of what do I do in this next stage of my life and how do I get there. He knows what he wants to do. He's a middle manager at this great paper plant. He's madly in love with this girl who is the kind of executive's daughter. He is friendly with those that he works with, but he shows up to work to perform every day. And he's not in competition with anybody, but he's not somebody that immediately draws your attention because he's not a threat. Humans only use like 12% capacity of their brain, and I really think Steve is using three times that, just because the visual complexities in this film are mind-numbing. And he's having to work out all of that, then work out all of the stunts and effects, and work with the performances, and leave his own mark on it. You know, I think the directors of this franchise have all done a very good job and set quite a precedent. But I don't know anybody that's more capable of it than Steve. Humans only use like 12% capacity of their brain, and I really think Steve is using three times that, just because the visual complexities in this film are mind-numbing. And he's having to work out all of that, then work out all of the stunts and effects, and work with the performances, and leave his own mark on it. You know, I think the directors of this franchise have all done a very good job and set quite a precedent. But I don't know anybody that's more capable of it than Steve. When you have a cast like ours that's just hilarious through and through, from David Koechner and PJ Byrne, Nick and Molly are hilarious. Ellen Rowe is just the sweetest little ball of energy you've ever seen. And everybody keeps it fairly lighthearted. There are shots that lend themselves more dynamically to 3D than just traditional two-dimensional film. Anything with depth, where things come right at the lens, or where your lateral movement's one thing, but to move like this literally is an entire different dimension. And so being aware of that, but not having it dictate the performance. You know, when Steve yells action, you act as you would, I think, in anything that's being filmed. But this movie also has extraordinary set pieces and such a large scale and scope that it's really doing justice to the medium.